this is Vince Guru, and today we are checking how to manage your kingdom. This video is dedicated to my subscriber who messaged me during those Blood Veil guilds and asked me to make a video of kingdom. So here it is, let's start. First of all, how you get your own kingdom. You get to manage kingdom after you have done the Throne of Miscellanea quest. Because on that quest, you have to sadly marry that pimpo princess or lazy ass prince who had no guards to stand next to his dad and take care of kingdom. So you step up and show how it's done. So what it does? What is the use of having kingdom? Think it like this. Those citizens in Miscellanea are working for you. They collect coal, logs, fish or flax, herbs, whatever you put them work on. Sounds nice, right? But like in any work, if you are the boss, you are the one who also pays for the work, gives the salary for done work. It is a bit like wholesale, you get stuff but you get them cheaper than you would get them in World 1. And how you go to your kingdom? Well, it is the same castle in Miscellanea, where you did also the Throne of Miscellanea quest. You can go there via Relekka, using boat, or you can use Fairy Ring Tele if you have done that Fairy Tale 2 quest to use those rings. You just dial CIP, and you get Tele there. At Quest Throne of Miscellanea, you had to get your approval rating to 75% to marry that lazy partner. But now that you want to put your money to work for you, you have to get that approval rating to 100% and keep it there. You want to be a good ruler, and to be one, you can't just lay and spit on ceiling while citizens are working. You have to go down to their level and work with them every day to keep your approval rating at 100%. When your approval is up, it doesn't need much to keep it there. But if you let it drop down, it is very annoying to get back up. It takes several minutes to work it back to 100%. It is very important to keep it at 100% because it keeps citizens happy and happy worker works harder and you don't want to waste your money, you know. Rating drops down like 1% per day, and if you don't go there for several days, you can see approval goes down pretty fast. It can drop down to 25%. Remember not to steal or kill in your kingdom, because no one wants to work for a bitch who is tapping on back or stealing from them. It hurts your approval rating and can drop down to null. How you raise your approval? Well, same way as you did in a quest. You can mine, fish or cut logs, or rake. Remember to have those items with you you normally use for those skills. If you want to fish, you need to have harpoon or cage. If you want to woodcut, you need to have axe. It doesn't matter what you do to raise your approval. You can fish even if you want to collect herbs for your money. It doesn't affect on collecting. When you have those 100% approval done, you get message that you can stop. Basically telling you that you are sweating too much, go wash your armpits. When you do that skilling to get that rating up, you do not get any experience, where barely any, and you don't get those items in your inventory. So don't expect to have any logs or coal. With Throne of Miscellanea quest, you get 10 citizens to work for you, but if you want max out your kingdom, you should also do Royal Trouble quest, because then you get 5 more citizens to boss around. You have to pay daily, of course. For that, there is coffin, you can deposit money, and that money is used to pay for those workers. The max amount money you can put in is 7.5 mil, but you can deposit as much you want or can, and salary for those citizens is like 10% whatever you have in this chest. The max salary they can take is like 75k per day. When your citizens are working, that work will be saved with that approval you had that day. And when you want to collect your items, you will get those with saved work. For example, if you let your approval go down to 60%, that work will be saved with that 60% that day. If you next day come and get up your rating to 100% and collect your items, that 100% do not affect on your last 60% saved work. This is why you should keep your approval rating all the time up. Because with low rating, you are wasting your own money. You pay max, but you only get part of it back. Because who would want to give you full amount of stuff if you are just party hard and let them work alone? You know, work morale drops down if you do not show them how to work. Now, if you watch this map, you can see there's many items your workers can collect for you. It depends of you what they will collect. You can put 10 citizens on the same skill, and if you have done that Royal Trouble cost, you can put 5 on other skill. Or spread them on every skill, up to you. I personally like to collect only two items at the same time. What you should collect, I can't tell it really, because depends what you want. If you want to sell items, you better look prices from world one and then count what gives the most profit. For example, right now it is not best time to collect maple, because price is the same in world one than you have to pay for workers, so you don't get profit out of that. If you want to use your stuff on your skills, collect here what you need or you don't want to collect yourself. You can always change workers to collect other stuff. If this week you want to have logs and next week you need coal, just take those citizens from woodcutting and put them to mine. But remember, change will affect on saved works. If you don't collect those saved materials before you change workers to collect other material. For example, if you have already logs waiting for you and you don't collect them before you change them to mine, you don't get logs when you will pick up your items. You will get only those coals. So remember, pick up before you do those changes. Also keep an eye that you don't have any sleeping workers. If you have, put them work on something, because there is no use to pay for a worker who is sleeping on work time. Just kick on their ass and make them to do something useful. Like I said, this work is like wholesale. With that salary you pay for them, you get items. Every material costs a different amount of money. You can see cost on list here. I will put it on the screen now. For example, coal is right now 91.6 coins. So this is what you will pay per collected material. Let's see one example how it really works. Let's say you put in coffin 150k and your approval is at 100. Your pay for workers is 15k, so they collect items with that. Now, if you have all those 15 working and let's say 10 of those are collecting coal and only 5 is collecting maples, that 15k would be divided 15 because that's how many workers you have working. You have 10 mining, so it means you will get coal with that 10k. One coal cost 91.6, so 10k divided with 91.6 coins is you get 109 coals. 5,000 was for maple, so 5,000 divided with 56.3 is around 89 logs. This is how it goes. But let's say if you had approval down to 50% and you collect now your items, your today cats wouldn't be 15k, it would be 15k multiply 0.5. It means you would get material only with 7,500 coins. See, your half of your money would be waste. So this is why it's good to keep your approval up. Also, you get some bonus items when workers are working for you. When they mine, you can get one gem per every 150 coal. Picking herbs, you can get one herb seed per 100 herbs and one bird nest per 100 maples, one casket or gem per 50 tuna, and so on. Here is the list. From bird nest you can get tree seeds or fruit tree seeds, even bird eggs. And from casket you can get gems or even key parts. Tunas gives also level 1 clues. So this is nice bonus, and this is also what you should think when you decide where you put your workers on. Do you want rather have logs and bird nest, or do you want to have casket, gems and a fish? I know it doesn't really make sense that when you use harpoon to cast tuna, you can get casket as bonus item, because those you should get with net. But oh well, bonus is always bonus, so let's not complain. You can always deposit money in the chest when you want, or if you need money you can withdraw away. Just make sure that you have enough in chest to pay those workers. Also, you can collect your items when you want, you don't need to do it every week, they are saved. When you want to collect, just talk with Grim and he will show you how much they have collected for you and then bank them for you. But make sure that you have space in bank, and if you don't have space, he will tell you to make some. Just go to Etceteria and there is bank and get rid of your crap and then go back to collect your items. If you feel like not doing this anymore, you can always stop managing your kingdom. You can leave your money in chest or take them away, whatever you want. Stop doing that approval and forget it all, but then don't expect to get any items when you go there next time. When you feel to start it again, you have to start to get rating back up and deposit money for base. I know I did ramble a lot and I hope I didn't forget anything important. But did you guys learn anything or did I just confuse you? I don't know. Let's repeat those main points once again. So, you should do both quests, Throne of Miscellanea and Royal Trouble, to get all those 15 workers. Keep your approval at 100% to get max out. Daily pay is 10% what you have in zest, but max is 75k per day. Approval can get up with working along with citizens, and you can use any skills if what you want, no matter what you will collect. Do not steal or kill in kingdom because it drops your rating. Make sure that you have money in your zest so you can pay for those workers. Make sure that all are working, don't let them slack. A sleeping worker is wasting your money. Work will be saved with approval you had that day. You don't need to collect items every day, but keep approval up every day. When you change worker to work on other skill, collect saved items before you make that change. Now, just to show you what all you can get when you collect your materials, I will show you peak from my other account. Take this as a bad example, because I haven't keep approval up. There is money in the chest, but I haven't checked my kingdom for months because I didn't want to see that whining prince for a bit. So yeah, there is not much to collect. But we will see. Oh dear, like I said, not much. If I had checked this kingdom all the time and keep my approval up, there would be much, much more to collect. But hey, at least I got that clue and also some gems. So I should be fine with this. And we will see you on next video. Bye!